Myself Jyoti from DAV Public School Mansa welcome all the students in this session which belongs to economics plus one especially with the introduction of microeconomics. Students, before starting this session I would like to discuss a real life activity with you. Students, suppose your mother has given you 100 rupees and sent to market to buy few commodities. Now you have 100 rupees in your pocket and the list of commodities you want to purchase is very big. So what type of problem arise in that time? This is called the problem of choice. So problem of choice will arise in front of you, that what goods should be purchased and what should be left. So in this way there is also a problem with every consumer, with every producer, with every government, because students, resources are limited. Why resources are limited? Because the human wants are unlimited. For example, a person who is very rich but his or her wants is unlimited as compared to his or her income, that's why the problem of choice arises. And the resources are limited as compared to wants. It leads to scarcity. We can call it scarcity. That is, resources are limited. And the second one is, resources are limited. And the other problem is, the resources of alternative use. Come back to the example. You have only 100 rupees. So, your money, your income is limited. And the second problem is, with 100 rupees, you can purchase multiple goods and services. So this is also the problem. Suppose with 100 rupees it is fixed that you can purchase only food, then how the problem will arise? You take 100 rupees and purchase food, but with money you can purchase multiple things. So multiple uses also is a problem of choice. So problem of choice, students, arises due to scarcity and multiple uses is the topic of this session. So economic problems, let's discuss them in detail. So students, why economic problems are called central problems? Because no economy is there where there is no economic problem. So it is the problem central to every economy. That's why these are called central problems of economy. Now the variations of these problems is what to produce, means what type of goods and services to be produced and in what quantity. Type of goods and in what quantity goods and services should be produced. And the second problem is how to produce these goods and services. And the next problem is for whom to produce these goods and services. Students, let's discuss these three central problems one by one. First problem again is what to produce. It means what type of goods and services and in what quantity should be produced. Students, as you have observed that this led to the problem of choice. If resources are unlimited, then there should be no problem of allocating the resources. The word allocation here means distribution of resources in the production of various goods. For example, an economy has to decide whether to produce consumer goods or producer goods, whether to produce essential goods or defense goods, because more of a commodity, less of the other. Reason is same, that is, resources are limited. When more of a good leads to less of the other, we have to make sacrifice. And this sacrifice in economics is called opportunity cost. What is opportunity cost, students? Opportunity cost means opportunity lost. For example, suppose economy decides to produce more consumer goods to increase the consumption level of an economy. So if consumer goods are produced more with the resources, but should have to be sacrificed, producer goods. So producer goods need to be sacrificed, leads to opportunity cost of consumer goods. Next problem is how to produce these goods and services. This is also a problem of choice. This time, producer has to decide the technology or technique of production. Students, for your knowledge, I am adding that technology can be of two types: labor intensive technology and capital intensive technology. What is the difference between both? In labor intensive, there is more use of labor as compared to capital. Capital means machines, and in capital intensive technique, there is more use of machines as compared to labor. Students, now if a country has surplus labor like India and the problem of unemployment is there, what type of technique should be used? Yes, labor intensive technique should be used, but in the advanced countries where there are more and more innovative techniques and machines are there, capital intensive techniques can be used. But you also know that with labor intensive techniques, one problem of unemployment can be solved, but the other problem is there that GDP cannot be risen by much extent. But with the help of capital intensive technique, the rise in GDP must be increased. Next is choice of the distribution of final goods and services. For whom to produce, students, means how these to whom these goods should be distributed, either rich section or poor section. So there should be balance between the distribution of the final goods and services. Not only the rich section should use the goods and services, but also poor section. If rich section is having more income, is given chance to consume more and more goods, then what will happen? The profits can be maximized because rich can afford the costly goods. But on the other hand, if poor section is also provided essential goods like elementary education, basic health facilities at low cost, what will happen? There is social welfare. So students, these are all the central problems of